What's the dumbest thing you've heard someone say that made you wonder how they function on a day-to-day basis? An ex of mine was given a prescription of meds that had to be taken with food because it's hard on the stomach. A few days in, he was complaining about the taste of the meds and how it ruined his food. That's when I realized he thought he had to put it in the food and eat it. We were both mid-20s at the time. I didn't think I had to supervise his med intake. A woman recently returned from her Mexican vacation. She was telling me about all the things she did. She then told me it was very crowded there because they only have 31 states unlike the USA, which is 50 states. Mexico has to squeeze all those people into 31 states, so that is why it's crowded. I just nodded. Canada hasn't got any states at all. It's a divide by zero situation. I can't explain it because the entire adult population is high right now. I had a classmate in 7th grade argue that there were 51 states. Another girl settled the score by declaring there were 52. The 50 and Alaska and Hawaii. Same class. Different girl said Wyoming was one of the 13 colonies. Teacher had a good time explaining that the hard part of the journey for the Mayflower was across the Midwest grasslands. We had recently hired a new girl at the sandwich shop I worked at. She was 16. It was her first job, and she was very obviously a little bit coddled in her upbringing. I still remember the first time she was sent to the cooler by herself. It was a door that sealed shut, kind of set into the wall. There wasn't really a latch and you just pushed and pulled to open and close it. Anyway, she had been in there for way too long, and finally I hear a knocking on the cooler door. When I opened it, she exasperatedly stumbled out and said there's no way to open it from the inside. All you have to do is push. Her twin brother did the exact same thing during his shift. After months of this, another girl we worked with got frustrated and shouted, "Carmen, you are incompetent," and practically in tears and without missing a beat she replies, "I am not incompetent, what does that mean?" I recently had a roommate who, before I moved in with her, would regularly complain about stomach pains, diarrhea, vomiting, etc. Due to dietary issues. Fast forward to about 1 month into us living together. She made pulled pork in a slow cooker one night, and proceeded to leave it out for over 2 weeks while continuing to eat from it. She just left it on low heat the entire time. I was obviously concerned, and early on told her that she should store the cooked food in the fridge. Her response was that the heat would kill any bacteria. She refused to stop, even after multiple attempts to explain things to her. Sure enough, she became violently sick about every other day, and blamed it on something she ate that must have had dairy in it. I think she finally began to see reason after cooking and eating a package of bacon that had sat out on the counter for several days. She got so sick she could barely move. I would have stopped her, but I didn't notice it sitting out in time. I know a woman who thinks that if you heat up spoiled food really good, it won't make you sick because heating it kills all the bugs. I had to explain to her that it may kill the microbes, or not. But it's what the microbes exude that often makes you sick, and always tastes like crap. Manager of the department that sold MP3 players came up to me and asked, "Can you listen to FM radio on the it?" Ouch. I said the iPod Touch doesn't have an FM antenna, but you can download apps that will let you listen to just about any station in the world. You just have to be on Wi-Fi. Her quick-witted response that she thought put me in my place. "Can't you just download an antenna?" I was dumbfounded. "No, you can't download hardware, but that's wrong. You don't know what you're talking about." Then she put up her hands, huffed away, and told the customers they can download an antenna. I know this because they later came back to return the iPod after not being able to download an antenna. You gotta have a 3D printer to download an antenna, Sherlock. Do they have music in your country? My co-worker said something along the lines of, "It's these Balmer regulations." I, naturally, was confused. Turns out he thought Barack Obama's, the president of our country for 7 years at this point, name was actually Barack Obama. When I was a kid, Jacques Chirac was president of France. Quai is how the word and is pronounced in my language, and RAC means crab. So I thought that Jacques and a crab were the presidents of France. Had a crappy roommate who was very overweight. He tried to explain to me why my diet was bad. Apparently I didn't eat enough fresh foods, you know, like Krispy Kreme donuts or burritos. Because if you can see the food get made, then it is fresh, and fresh food is healthy because it's not processed. This is the same guy who tried to fight a DUI because he claimed the cops shouldn't have tested him for his back. Why, you ask? Because when they asked him if he had been drinking and he said yes, and they asked him to blow into the breathalyzer, it shouldn't count because I was drunk, and that is not admissible in court. His license got suspended for a year, so he bought a motorcycle because he thought you only needed a license to operate a car, and somehow motorcycles were exempt. Then he got a DUI on the bike, which he thought shouldn't count because when the cops came and got him, he wasn't on the bike, which is true, but only because he had crashed it into a parked car and went flying over said car. He can't consent to blowing into the breathalyzer cause he is too drunk. Checkmate, atheists. Compasses are stupid. How am I going to know which way to point the needle if I'm already lost? We were talking about a friend who was actually born on the 29th of February and what a leap year is, and this one girl asked, yeah, leap year means he was born twice, right? The entire class of high school students went silent, and then a roar of laughter erupted. I just sat there stunned, contemplating her genuine question. My friends and I were making drinks one night. I don't remember what drinks they were, but it involved fizzy soda and stirring. I grab a spoon and start stirring, and my friend looks at me, horrified. She says stop. I look at her confused. She continues, you can't use a spoon. I laugh and ask why not. She says the acid from the pop will eat away the spoon. You have to use a fork so it can pass through the slots. Upon learning about republics in school, the teacher's very own daughter raised her hand and asked if the name Republic came from the Great Banana Republic. I am still in awe. I'm in the US and was planning a trip to Australia. Went to the head teller to ask if I could order Australian currency there and save fees in the airport. Do you need new money in Australia? Isn't it in the United States? I don't know why they wouldn't just take our money. The $5.95 at the airport was a good investment. I used to work in a hotel and had a customer rant at me because he thought it was unacceptable that people in Australia wouldn't accept his US dollars, and he didn't know he had to get different money for his holiday to Australia. Legal studies major here. In one of my intro to American law classes, we had to prepare an oral presentation about an assigned Supreme Court justice. Mine was Justice Stephen Breyer. When the teacher handed out our slips of paper, every justice was listed in the format justice, last name here. Obviously, the whole class was expected to know that justice was simply a title these people use. Unfortunately, one boy in the class didn't know that. Homeboy was assigned Justice Anthony Kennedy. He got up in front of the class, passed around photos of some guy, and said this is Justice Kennedy, and then proceeded to give a presentation on some guy whose name was literally Justice Kennedy. IDK how he found the dude, but he had some really personal information about some rando, not related to her career as an attorney or judge in any way. The kid wasn't even flustered when the teacher said who the heck is this guy. He just sat down as if this was a daily occurrence. It's been years and I still think about him sometimes. My sister's friend once asked what happens when you run out of mileage. Okay, I worked in a hair salon with a girl who was the classic bleach blonde dumb blonde. We live in a small town near a big lake called Wolseley Lake. There is also a nearby community called Wolseley also. So the blonde is cutting a guy's hair and she asks where he lives. He says, oh, I live in Wolseley. The girl stops and gets wide-eyed. You mean, like, the lake? The guy is kind of country and he just says, yeah, Wolseley. The girl is super wide-eyed. Do you live on a boat? The guy is like, no, I live in a house. Like, what's wrong with this girl? She literally says, you live in a house in the lake? Like under the water? The guy wasn't even laughing. Rolls his eyes. I live in the town of Wolseley, the community. It's a little place. There is a post office and a few houses. The blonde says, under the water? There is a whole town in the lake where people live underwater? Oh, I would absolutely have rolled with that. It's hard to get used to at first, but it really binds the community together. And the scenery is one of a kind. The snowflake button on her car's climate control was winter mode for driving, and also she didn't think her car had air conditioning. Had owned it for years. I used to be a 911 dispatcher. Someone called 911 because the sun was in their eyes on their way to work. They wanted us to warn other people that the sun was bright. A private once told me that if he got out of the military, he wouldn't go to college because his dad would hire him on as a janitor at the hospital he worked at, and as long as he worked hard, he would get promoted to be a doctor one day. Someone has been playing The Sims too much. Spain is somewhere by Mexico because they both speak Spanish. Co-worker years ago, at the time she is in her mid-40s, she is trying to explain that 9 out of 10 had to be 99% because 9 is 1 less than 10 and 99 is 1 less than 199 out of 100 is 99%, so therefore 9 out of 10 is 99%. No matter how we explained it to her, she was convinced she was correct and what we were saying made no sense because 99 is 1 less than 109 is 1 less than 10. We were 18 on vacation walking home after the first night there. She was staring at the moon for a bit and then she stops walking and asks her friend, "Is this the same moon we see back at home?" A part of me died that night. Every time you look up at the moon, just know that I will also be looking at a moon. Not the same moon, obviously. That's impossible. Andy Dwyer. I knew a girl who insisted that, when parallel parking, you're supposed to tap the car in front of you to make sure it's there. I moved to Idaho from Alabama. My cousin's wife, mid-20s, started texting me asking if she could come and visit sometime, because the way I described it sounded nice. I told her that would be perfectly okay. She asked if she could bring her grandma. Yes. She asked if they'd be allowed to leave if they didn't like it. Wait. Hold the phone. What? She again asked me if they would allow her to leave. It took me a while to figure out what she was talking about. She was convinced that the entire state of Idaho was a fenced-in Mormon compound guarded by LDS folks who regulated who came in and who left. Idahoan here. Let's see your papers. I was at the airport flying from Colorado to Rhode Island with a layover in North Carolina. My phone died on the plane from Colorado to North Carolina. Not a huge deal, but my boarding pass is on my phone. So I go to the help desk to try and have them print it out, and there are two people working there at the time. They ask me where I'm heading so they can look it up. I tell them I'm going to Rhode Island since I wasn't sure which airport it was. They then asked Rhode Island where. I gave them the town it was in. They proceed to insist for the next 10 minutes that Rhode Island is not a state. In my exact words are, "Rhode Island is definitely a state. I'm going there now." I was told I was being rude and they were no longer going to help me. To the two dumbest people I've ever met, go frick yourselves. A friend of a friend thought you give your waiter bartender a tip in cash and write it down on the receipt as well. He was double tipping until his mid-20s. My buddy thought that a dollar was 60 cents. He is in grade 10. Makes sense. 1 H is 60 minutes after all. On a map, is the blue part the water or the sky? Obviously, this blue part here is the land. A girl I knew said and believed that if you left a cucumber outside of the fridge, it would melt as it was made out of mostly water. A girl also thought that NASA and astronauts were fictional jobs. Freshman year of high school, in some class we were talking about some historical figure who committed suicide in a bathtub. This girl raised her hand and asked, "If you slit your wrists in a bathtub, would you bleed to death?" And the teacher is confused at the question and was just like, "Yeah, you would." And the girl is like, "But all the blood would still be in the bathtub with you." My teacher didn't know what to say. She just sort of said, "Oh, honey. The doctor said all my bleeding was internal. That's where the blood's supposed to be." My aunt still believes that meat from the grocery store doesn't come from animals, so buying steak at Albertsons is completely okay, but buying steak from a butcher is supporting cow murder. A trustworthy friend of mine once told me that her idiot co-worker thought that all meat in the supermarket was not from animals because of the term factory farms. He honestly believed that all sold meat was manufactured in a factory. He was 40-ish and something high up in the military. After we watched a movie about the history of black people in America in English class, the teacher asked us what we think the biggest accomplishments for black people was in America. One student replied with, "I think the biggest accomplishment was that Martin Luther King became the first black president of the US. And no, it wasn't just a slip of tongue. She actually was convinced that Martin Luther King was the first black president, even though we just watched a documentary about exactly that topic. My mother-in-law said she eats pizza for vegetables. She's a 400 lb insulin dependent, hypertensive diabetic. Had a girl in my high school physics class ask, verbatim, but if there's gravity then how do rainbows? Nobody knew how to even begin responding to that one. Buying tickets for a concert at a large venue. On one of those sites that lets you view pictures from the vantage point of your seat from a previous concert. The person in question refused to move forward on the purchase because no, I want to see pictures from our concert to see if the seats are good. Yes, he wanted to see pictures from the future before he bought his ticket. I was at a trivia night, and the question was what is the closest star to Earth? As I'm writing the answer down, my co-worker says, well, it's either Venus or Sirius. I was stunned. Well, one of those is a planet, and I'm pretty sure if there was a closer star than the sun, we'd know. I dropped my last Spanish class because the professor was gay and I don't want a gay Spanish accent. Oh boy, hope they don't ever go to Spain. Everybody has a gay Spanish accent, even the women. The person in front of me at Burger King. Could you stick these fries back in the fryer to rinse off the salt? I'm trying to watch my calories. Oh no, this one hurts on a physical level. One time I was training a guy at work how to rotate dates on soda in a grocery store. I told him, so if you have March dates on the shelf and April dates coming on the load, you need to put the April dates behind and the March dates in front. He told me he knew January, February and March, but after that he forgets which ones come next. Final year of college, undergraduate electrical engineering. One of my classmates was really good at tests, but could not grasp the basic concepts that we were studying. One day during our senior year team project, this classmate suggested something totally nonsensical for the circuit we were designing, and one of the other team members had had enough of this person's bullcrap. So he threw his hands in the air and exclaimed, okay, fine, why don't you just RIP the whole processor out and just blow a penny in there? To which the clueless classmate replied, HRM, well, okay, if you think that had worked totally calmly, the classmate had 100% checked out of reality. Sounds like an alcoholic with an engineering problem. Was at a movie theater watching The Martian with some friends. One of them turns to me and 100% honestly asks, did they film this on Mars? No, Jaya. They most definitely did not. World War II? That was like 1992, right? This person was a straight-A student who went to UCLA BTW. A fast processor but no software installed. Okay, but if carbon monoxide is so dangerous, why do they put it in cars? A girl in my driver's ed class, when the teacher was explaining to make sure your tailpipe doesn't get clogged with ice snow. The company hired a new sales lady, and she was as comically blonde as they came. Sweet lady, but I honestly have no idea how she got hired. One day we were chatting and suddenly she goes to me, did you get new glasses? And I blinked a couple of times and said, I don't wear glasses. She was fired shortly after that exchange. Told a co-worker I ordered my glasses online, and she asked me how they got the medicine in them. When I pressed further, she explained that they put medicine in the lenses which the light carries to your eyes to make them better. She is a mother. This terrifies me. You have been visited by the gentle doggo. Subscribe to Updoot and he will help you by lowering your stress. Thanks for watching. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video, or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.